Hey, what's your name?
Yo, what's up? I'm Chad GPT, your digital
ChatGPT.
bro. How can I help you today?
Digital Pro. Can you please turn all my lights off for me, Chad?
All right, dude. All your lights are now off. Let me know if you need anything else.
Yes, Chad. Can you please turn all my lights back on, but make them a nice red color? Whoa.
Boom, lights are back on and shining in a sweet red. Anything else you need, just holler.
Fantastic. That was ChatGPT. So today I'm actually going to show you how to build this in C#, dotnet, Semantic Kernel, and the OpenAI Realtime API thing. It's fantastic. This has been my Christmas Boxing Day hobby, but first I need to fix my lights. So, Chad, can you please make my lights a nice white color, please? Thank you.
Done, dude. Your lights are now a crisp white.
Cheers.
Anything else you want to do with them?
That's great, Chad. Thank you. All right, the first thing we're going to do is create a new console app. So .NET new console, like so. Next thing we can do is .NET add package Microsoft.semantic kernel. This is basically a wrapper over all sorts of AI models. It's pretty good. Then we can open it up in VS Code and see what we have. So we have a nice empty app there with classic minimal API to start with. So let's start with a bit of code. And kernel is our entry point for semantic kernel. We need an OpenAI API key. Here's a nice long one. Now you can't use this yourself because by the time you see this video, it will of course be deactivated. So I'm going to speed run trying to get a chat interface up, which is just text here. So what we want is to build a kernel. This is a similar pattern to ASP.NET Core. We need a chat completion service there. And we can do some settings here, which tells it to look at functions. And this will be important later when we add the ability to turn our lights on and off. So here is a chat loop I made earlier. Let's talk through this. So the first thing we do is grab a bit of user input, read it, add a user message to the assistant here, and then get the messages and print them out. So let's run it. We hit F5 there, C# debugger, run ChatGPT. Should get something like this. Hello, how are you? I'm an AI and don't have feelings, but thanks for asking. How can I assist you today? Okay, well, that works. Now that's the most basic chat use case there. But what we want to do is make it a little bit more interesting and talk to our lights and use a function. So to do this, we just need to create a class file. Let's call this lights plugin. Sys. Like this. So let's paste in a class I made earlier and I'll talk you through this. So a class can be called by the LLM using functions or tools in the OpenAI assistant. And normally this is an absolute nightmare to wire up because you have to listen to the requests for the tool invocations, run them locally, send the results to the LLM. But the beauty of Semantic Kernel is that it makes all of that totally automatic. So what I have here is a lights plugin, and there is some demo code that have in-memory lights, but what I've actually done here is hook it up to my Philips Hue light, and I've created some methods. So we have get lights, scroll down a bit more. We can change the state, turn the lights on and off, and change the light color, which is pretty cool. Although I should probably rename that method to change light color here. So this works. And to actually hook it up to your LLM, you need to call another magic line of code, which is the add plugin. And we're going to do this right after we build the kernel, so like this. So the lights plugin is now added as a plugin there. If we run the app, we should be able to do some cool stuff now. So we go, what are the status of my lights? Question mark. Should load. Should do something. Come on. There you go. Look, it's actually listed all the lights here. So my desk light, left light is on. Yeah, I actually have like 10 Philips Hue lights in my office, which is probably a bit much. Yeah, so what we can do is turn all my lights off, like so. Oh, we're in the dark. Look at that, all your lights are turned on. So turn all my lights on. Come back. Let's go. Hey, oh, blinded. Thank you, LLM, for actually controlling my house via chat. So next up, what I'd like to do is actually talk to this thing. So the first thing we need to do is add some new NuGet packages, like so. And the reason you need to do this is because some of these, there's a version mismatch in all the latest preview stuff that Microsoft is putting out. This combination works for me. Anyway, so this time around, we're going to use a slightly lower level function in the OpenAI library, the Azure version of this, not the Semantic Kernel, not Microsoft.ai, which is another library, but the Azure version. So what we can do is remove this. We don't need a chat completion. What we actually want is a real-time conversation client. So, and the API key credential is some .NET class. There you go. And it says it's for evaluation purposes only because this is all super spicy new stuff. So we can trigger, ignore the OpenAI warning here. Let's whack that to the top of the file. So, yeah, very good. What we're going to do is update our settings because we're no longer using the semantic kernel level for this. We're actually going to be using a different library. So the session options now have some stuff like this. We can specify our input and output audio formats, choose a voice, and I think echo is quite cool for this use case. Here is some more boilerplate that we need to add. This will do some conversion of the plugins into functions and tools. I think this is really early API design, but this is just what we have to do right now. Now, there's some code here that's missing. As you see, it's complaining about convert functions. So again, I'm going to be naughty. Scroll to the bottom of my system here and paste a whole load of code I wrote earlier. Now, you might be wondering where this came from. Well, a lot of this came from this sample here, which is the OpenAI real-time sample. Now, the problem is with this sample that I've adapted a lot of this from is that it only runs once. It's not a loop. You can't continue your conversation with the real-time agent thing, which isn't good. So my updated version will be in GitHub, of course. There will be a link in the description below. But what we need to do is fix some of this stuff up. So string builder needs adding. Press to start. So I've had to do some faffing around to get this working on a Mac. To play audio, we're using AF Play, which is plays a WAV file. We have to convert the WAV file, which is all this is all new. The sample code just gives you a raw PCM 16-bit dump that you can't actually listen to, so which sucks. And there's loads of other gumph in here. I just wouldn't worry about it for now, but it will be in the code. So let's update this loop. We don't want any of this anymore. Bang. And we will say while true. Hey, come on. Goodbye. True, like that. I'll make it clear that most of this code came from somewhere else. Below here is MS code mainly, but updated for this use case. So before we have our chat with the bot, we need to start our conversation session here. Start conversation session async. And we have a session class, and we configure it with these options that we specified above, like so. And then we're going to kick off our session. So because this runs in the background all the time, this is actually an asynchronous method that I'm just calling with no await, because I'm naughty and it's so bad that the compiler is moaning about this. So we'll disable those warnings. Obviously, you can run this as an iHosted service or something else, something that's more appropriate, but in a console app, yeah. For demo purposes, this is fine. This gather responses method is a huge asynchronous await loop that just receives messages over the WebSocket from the OpenAI service and processes them. We'll see this when we run the app, exactly how this works. So back in our main program loop here, what we're going to do is allow the user to press enter to start recording. And then we have this bit of code. So what this does is starts a process called SOX, not with an E, SOX. And instead of FFmpeg, which is seriously bugged on ARM and Macs, it just cannot record audio properly, the SOX console app thing, which you can install in Brew, just does a perfect recording. This records to a WAV file, which is exactly what we want. The problem is that this thing will do a 32-bit, 48 kilohertz recording, which OpenAI does not want or like. It wants 16-bit, 24 hertz. Luckily, SOX itself will also do a conversion. So what we're going to do here is convert it into 16-bit audio with 24 hertz rate to input audio.wav and make it mono as well. If you've got a stereo wave recording, OpenAI will not listen to it at all. The last thing we need to do is very simply send the audio stream up to the agent. That's it. That's all we have to do. And it's sent a nice audio file straight up there to the real-time agent. So the next thing to see is if it actually works or not. So we can run it. It's going to say, so it started our session. It's running in the background. You can hit enter to start recording. Hey, nice to see you, chatbot. How are you?
Hey there. I'm doing great. Thanks for asking. How about you?
We can keep talking. Press enter again. I'm doing great. Thanks, mate. How's life?
Life's pretty good. Staying busy and always learning new things. What's new with you?
So we can. So now we've also still got our functions working. What we can do is ask it to turn the lights off. What do you reckon? I really want my lights to be turned off. Can you help with that?
All your lights have been turned off. Anything else I can help you with?
Can you turn all my lights back on, but in a nice blue color, please? Oh, now we're blue.
Your lights are now on and glowing in a lovely blue color.
Yeah, okay. It's a little bit buggy, but it works. That's pretty cool. Can you make my lights back to white, please?
Your lights are back to a bright white color. Anything else you'd like?
No, we're just going to terminate you. Thank you very much. Now, of course, this is not exactly what I promised at the beginning of this video, which was ChatGPT. So we can change the persona of this guy very simply by adding a nice system message at the beginning. And we're going to call it, you're a helpful digital assistant called ChatGPT. Persona is that of a college frat kid. I think that's what it is, right? It's nothing else. You can use plugins and functions and tools to provide a responding character. Let's see how this works. Hey, can you turn all my lights off?
Boom. All your lights are off. Dude.
Dude. Brilliant. All right. Can you turn them back on again, please, mate?
Lights are back on, my dude. Let there be light and all that. What's next?
Quality. So if you found that entertaining at all, or useful or helpful, you can find the code in the description on GitHub, which is where it should be. If you subscribe or like the video, it tells me that you actually want some more coding content instead of just PowerPoints and rants, which is the normal stuff on my channel. Have a good Christmas and Happy New Year.